had to make sure I look cute, cause y'all know this is a shoe store, so all the niggas gonna be in here, so.
Santa baby, slip a sable under the tree for me. Been an awful good girl, Santa baby. Hurry down the chimney tonight.
Hey y'all, what's poppin'? Welcome back to my channel. For today's video, I'm gonna start this video off with talking about my hair that I have in my head. This wig is so bomb and effortless. I just love it. It's basically the best wash and go like curly wig that I ever had. This hair is from Modern Show Hair Company. This is their 150 dent Malaysian curly wig. Oh my god, y'all, it's so freaking bomb. And I would show y'all like the lace in person right now, but you're gonna see it in the install and in the vlog how flawless it is, how it looks like scalp. It's transparent. I love transparent lace. Those are the vibes, because they look like scalp. And somebody asked me the other day, they was like, is that your hair? And I was like, you know, it's a wig. But this wig is so flawless, like I cannot express it enough. So I just added these jelly soft curl this mousse to it, just to give it that light bounce. I don't like to add too much. And look how freaking soft these curls look. Like, the wig is giving me so much life right now, and I just love it, because when I don't have on makeup and my hair is like this, I just look fresh and rejuvenated, and I love it so much. So fresh, cute, and effortless. So yeah, so all the hair details will be in the description box below. So I hope you guys enjoy. Don't forget to like, comment, subscribe, and don't forget to shop Modern Show Hair Company. So yeah, let's just hop right into the install and then hop right into the vlog. cute lighting, okay? So y'all, I just went to Target to do a little Target haul because I was supposed to do a drive with me today. So I'm gonna just film it in the morning because it just got too late and it's too dark out for me. But y'all, I got some cute pieces at Target. Like, I literally never go to the clothing section because I know I'm gonna be like distracted. You already know when you go to Target, you only come there for one thing, one thing only, but leave with 20 million fucking things. But yeah, so today I just decided to browse and I was like, damn, that's cute. So I'm like, let me try this stuff on first because y'all know, like, these little department stores and shit, they don't really size for the slim thick, you know? So I had to go in there and try on my shit. Good thing I did. So I'm gonna insert, while I'm telling y'all what I got, I'm gonna insert like the clothes that I got, just to show y'all like the full body, like, try on. Yeah, I need to get real diamonds. So I got this cute pink utility one piece. Oh my god, I cannot wait. It's a large, they only had a small, no medium, but I am gonna go get this taken in so it can be real super cute on me. This gave me real Kylie Jenner vibes. I just really loved it and I'm gonna insert a clip. Like I said, this is in a large. It's so cute. It's corduroy pink girly. Oh my god, y'all, when I tried this on, I'm like, yes, this is so fucking cute. I need it. So I got that. Then I got this furry baby pink cardigan. I've been wanting like those pink trench coats, but I haven't found one. And I just wanted something like cute and girly to wear, like with like a cute little tank, some sweatpants, leggings, like when I'm just chilling. So I got this. It's super cute. And I got me a little Fashion Nova set in this mug. I'm happy I tried this one on because the bottoms was like, no. So I tried these on in a medium in the top and a small, but I ended up getting a large in the bottoms. It's like this cute, like orangey, like dusty orange color. And then it comes in a hoodie, with a hoodie. So I got this in a medium for that slouchy, oversized feel, you know. I was like, damn, okay, Target, the fuck? Oh, I got a white thermal because I wanted to just have something to wear with like some leggings or like sweatpants, like on an everyday. It's cute. I wish they had it in black, but I just got it in white, and this is a small. And then I just got some duct tape because I need to shut you bitches up, okay? Like, y'all talking too motherfucking much for me, baby. Like, zip it. No, I'm playing. No, I got duct tape for my drive with me tomorrow so it don't be, you know, going everywhere. And then I just got some Stella Rose black because I really wanted to make a video with y'all. It's gonna come, y'all are gonna see. It might actually, you know what, fuck it, I'm gonna just do it in this vlog. Basically, my plaque came today, y'all. My plaque came. I didn't open it yet. I'm so excited. Let me cover my address. I'm so excited to open it when I get home, and I wanted to unbox it with y'all. So I got one. I literally came to Target to get wine to just sip it up with y'all, to just cheers to everything y'all have done for me. But we're gonna get to that later. So yeah, I gotta be on my way because I gotta go get my shoes. So I'm gonna do that. Why he not replying? Be on my way to this shoe store. If you're from the Wisconsin area, you'll know, like, you know how like New York has like, what's that store called, I forgot, you know, it's like a little local shoe store. So there's one downtown Milwaukee, and I hit up the dude. I'm like, I really want these shoes, can you help me get them? He was like, yeah, for sure, baby, I got you. And I was like, yes. So I'm about to be on my way. He had ordered them for me. It's those glossy ones, the orange and black ones. I really wanted those shoes. Like, I just really been wanting some ones, like, and those are popping. So I'm about to be on my way to get them now. So yeah, let's just, you know, continue on with the vlog. It's 5 o'clock, so we got plenty of time to do a vlog, even though it's late as fuck. And I'm supposed to be going to the movies with my mama because me and my mama have not seen Queen of Slim, so I want to just take her to that. So
yeah, we're gonna go. So I'll talk to y'all in a second when I get there.
Jacquees, like, I'm over here getting fucking chills. Like, he is such a vibe. Like, damn, I need a man so I can be like, ooh, like, I know. Let me shut up, because I'm gonna be addressing it in another video. But it was a little comment, was like, sis always saying she's single, we get it. Bitch, I don't care. I'ma scream I'm single until I'm single. And if you got a nigga, I'm still gonna scream I'm single, cause you bitches will never know I got a nigga. And that's just that, okay? So, shut the fuck up. I can do what the fuck I want. And you guess what? Guess what the best thing about it is? I can say what the fuck I wanna say, and you're still gonna fucking watch. Ah, that's the fucking gag.
Okay, y'all, so I made it down here. I had to make sure I look cute, cause y'all know this is a shoe store, so all the niggas gonna be in here, so. But I'm about to cross the street. It's so cold. I know people looking at me like, she got no coat on. I'm like, I know. Okay, come on, let's go. Okay, y'all, so I just came and got my shoes. Look at the drip. Wait, open it up for me. Okay, my boy Rico. Make sure y'all come to Trusted Kicks in Milwaukee.
Come see us, man. We got all the hot shit for y'all to come pick up. Come see us.
Period. So I just got my shoes. My shoes, my kicks, my drip. So yeah, make sure y'all check out Rico's Instagram. I will have him and his store linked below. He ships out to people and he's really good. Like, talk to him on Instagram. I was on his ass and he was like, girl, I got you. And yeah, it didn't even take that long either. It took like a couple days, but I'm an impatient bitch. But for me to be impatient, it didn't take that long. So make sure y'all go fuck with him. But anyways, I'm about to be on my way to go get some vegan food. It's this vegan place in Milwaukee. I mentioned in a couple vlogs, I go here to get my like post-workout like green juice, and I never tried their food before, but my sister had it the other day and I tried some and it was fire. So I'm gonna get some of that. When I get a chance to eat healthy, I'm gonna eat healthy. Like, there's just not much around me to choose from, so I just be like stuck on Panera, and that's just about it, or tuna if I make it at home, or whatever I make at home. So I'm just about to get some of that right now. I'm so excited because I'm so hungry. Hopefully they're still open, so. Okay, y'all, so I just got home and this is the pizza. It looks so good. Well, it is good actually, because I ate some. But yeah, buffalo cauliflower pizza. So I'm just about to eat really quick and then we're gonna crack open this wine, bitch, because I'm about to unbox my thing and I want to do it with y'all. So let me just eat, get situated real quick, and then I'm gonna come back and we're gonna do this. We're gonna pop bottles. Hey, no, I'm playing. Hey, let's pop open our little wine. Hold up. Yeah, I'm fucking thirsty. So here we have the Stella Rose. Bitch, get your glass out. Get your ice. Fuck, it's a cork in this one. Fuck. Damn it. Hold on. I gotta go get a fucking cork. True. What should I do for y'all? Motherfuckers die. Motherfuckers stare. Last bitch, here you go. There you go. Okay. Okay. Okay, cheers. Cheers to all the blessings we finna have in 2020, bitch. Like, we finna be accomplishing all of our goals in 2020, and that's just that, and that's period. So let's drink up, okay? I wanna give a toast to y'all. Thank y'all so much for always supporting me. I hope that y'all accomplish all of y'all goals in 2020, and anything you set your mind to, you can definitely do it. So cheers up, baby, to that, okay? Ding, bitch. Cover it up. This is crazy. Oh my God, I can't believe this. I don't wanna get emotional. When it first came, I was like, oh my God, like, I can't believe it's here. Like, I can't believe this day has come. It's like Christmas. And y'all got me this gift, honestly. So they give you a little letter. It says, you have done something that very few YouTuber creators accomplished. You had an astonishing 100,000 people subscribe to your channel. We know the numbers on YouTube can get really big, but we hope that you don't lose sight of the reality behind the six-digit milestone. Each and every person who has subscribed to your channel has been touched by what you created. Oh, this is so cute. I'm already like getting emotional. It's crazy as fuck. Kirah, I'm unique. Oh, it's a little mirror. It's so cute. This is so fucking awesome. Like, I can't believe I even hit this milestone, y'all. Like, it seems like it's so, like, far away when you first start. Like, oh my God, 100,000. Like, am I ever gonna get there? You definitely will get there. You just gotta be consistent. And if you want it bad enough, you will put the work in. Like, I remember when I was working my 9-to-5, and I'm like, how I'm gonna do this? How I'm gonna go to work? And I was going from 8:30 to 5. That's basically the whole fucking day. And then I was like, you know, how I'm gonna edit when I get home? Cause when I get home, I'm so fucking tired. Like, when am I gonna, like, film my videos? Because I'm just so exhausted. But I dedicated my weekends to filming, and then on the weekdays when I got off of work, I would come home and edit. And then if I really wanted to get a video up that night, I would take my computer with me and edit, like, in the car, like, on my lunch break. Like, I wasn't fucking around. So this is just crazy to me. Like, I can't believe I have 100,000 people. Like, it doesn't seem like it's a lot to probably some people, but, like, this is, like, really everything. And I feel like I made it, even though I'm not growing as fast as some other YouTubers or whatever, but I really feel like I'm making a connection, like, with my subscribers. Like, it might be slow, but each and every time I upload a video, I feel like I'm connecting to my subscribers on a personal level. Like, I really feel like y'all are getting to know me, and y'all are seeing me grow as a person. And like, when I first started, like, I didn't have support, like, because people, like, I'm from a small town. So it's just like, what, YouTube? Like, how, what are you gonna do? Like, how? Just didn't know how or where to start. So when I told people I was gonna, like, just do YouTube, because I was always on YouTube, like, from, like,
middle school, been following Jayla Corian when she was in high school, on her way to college. Like, she was doing like hair reviews, because I would look up like sew-ins because I was getting like my hair, and I was like, oh, who is this? Like, I was just following her. And then Aaliyah J, I was always following her. And but yeah, anyway, like I was saying, Aaliyah J is like my biggest inspiration, because like, just to her, like, overall, like, what she's been through, I can just relate to her on that level. So, but yeah, so I first started YouTube in February was when I first posted my first video, and I really wasn't focused because I was still like in a rocky place with who I was messing with at the time. And then I wasn't really focused. I was only focused when we was like broken up or whatever, not talking. So then May 2018 is when I really started to take it serious, because that was like my last time fucking with him. Like, I'm not fucking with you. Like, I'm just gonna focus on this or whatever. Like, I'm gonna do my own shit. Like, fuck that. So that happened. And then like, I wanted to hit 100,000 by the end of 2019, which is this year. Like, I wanted to, you know, hit my milestone. I was reading notes the other day, like, I wanted to hit the 550k. like, I was saying this literally last year, like in the summertime. And then August 2018 is when I first started getting paid from YouTube. I got $600 with my first YouTube check, and that was from my $1 a day video. And then I just started getting paid from it. And then that was only from YouTube, not my sponsorship. So when my sponsorship emails coming in, it's just like, oh my god, like, I'm really doing this, I'm making money, but I'm still at the same time creating content, which is what I love to do, and showing y'all like how to be queens. Like, you don't have to depend on nobody. Like, you don't have to depend on no man. Self-care, you can feel beautiful on your own, you can make yourself feel good. I get depressed sometimes, I get a lot of anxiety. Like, I just want y'all to relate to me on like a personal level, where y'all can just come to my channel and give positive vibes. Because I remember when I was this one, I didn't have a YouTube yet, but I remember when me and my dude was always arguing, blah blah blah, but I would literally turn on Aaliyah J's channel, and I would just feel like 10 times better. Like, I'm just like getting laughs and stuff like that, just forgetting about what's really happening in reality. And I come to YouTube and I'm watching her, and I'm just like, there's like not a care in the world. Like, I'm just watching my bitch, like, and it's all positive vibes. And I just want y'all to get that feeling too. Like, when y'all come to my channel, I want y'all to get like positive vibes, positive energy, just to be motivated and inspire y'all to be the best you, like the best woman you can be. And I know y'all are like, I know y'all are like, are you still pursuing nursing, da da da. I really had to take a step back from like school, because school is always going to be there, nursing is always going to be there. But then it's crazy, because when I had quit, when I had went part-time to accomplish, because I really wanted to get 100,000 subscribers, so I'm like, how am I gonna do this? I need to post more, because I was working so much at my other job. Like, and they didn't give a fuck about me. They don't give a fuck about me. So I'm like, I need to go part-time. I can't be here no more. I need to focus on me. I need to get to where I want to be in life. Like, I need to accomplish my own goals. Like, I can't sit here. Like, sometimes I would be at my old job, I wouldn't be doing shit. Like, I could be like, I can be editing a video right now, I could be filming right now, I could be taking content for Instagram. So, and taking content is what I love to do. I love taking pictures, I love being glam, I just love that. And I just love that y'all just get inspired to go get y'all hair done, y'all nails, all that. Because sometimes we do need that little push to, for somebody to make us feel good about ourselves, because sometimes we won't fucking do it. We won't do it, and then we have that one person that just like, oh, since she's getting it done and I'm seeing it, fuck it, I'm finna go get my shit done too. Like, I wanna feel good too. Like, after you see how it makes somebody else feel, you wanna get that feeling too. So yeah, I just love y'all so much. Like, my life has been a whole 360. Like,
I was like not making a lot of money. Like it was just so irritating. And then like I would be, people thought I came real dependent on my partner, like who I was messing with, because he was really taking care of me. So it was just like, oh my god. Then all that shit happened. So it's just like I need to focus on my own bag. Like I don't need nobody taking care of me, blah blah blah. So yeah, that was that. I don't know, I'll be so like all over the place. But yeah, I'm actually gonna start this over because I feel like I'm just talking. I just feel like I'm just talking all over the fucking place. Like 100,000 subscribers. Sorry to mine. Somebody was saying like, oh, she just light skinned, that's why she get all these views. Oh, she's light skinned and pretty, that's why people like her, blah blah blah. She's just light skinned and got lucky. No, I really feel like I make content that people want to see. People are entertained. People want to just tune in. People want to know what I'm doing. And I love that. That's what I love. I want to inspire people. I want to help people do what they have to do to feel good about themselves and let them become the best them, like the best woman they can be. Like I don't feel like I got lucky, because if I did, I would be way further than I am now as far as subscriber count. And also I really feel like it would have been quicker than it was. People think I had like quickness to get in subscribers, but no, it was a lot of work for me, and I put a lot of work in, a lot of time. I was really consistent. I'm always engaged with my supporters. I'm not like think I'm too good to respond to that. No, I love talking to y'all, and this is what I love the most to do. So this is for y'all, this is for all of us. Like this is crazy. Like I don't know how to feel. Like, I never thought I would get something like this. When I first started my YouTube, when I was posting on, like, Instagram and stuff like that, and Facebook, I mean, people reshared or whatever, and then it wasn't, like, consistent support. It was just, like, they'll see me post my first video, and then, like, a lot of people would repost it, and then, like, after that, every time I would post something, like, the less the people would like, you know, share it with people. So I just really feel like, but it wasn't that many people, it was really like 4 people like that probably shared my shit on Facebook or something like that. I don't know who was sharing it on Instagram, because like people wasn't saying like, oh, go subscribe to Kirah's channel, go subscribe, blah blah blah. Like nowadays, like people would look at me and be like, what are you gonna do on YouTube? Like, what are you gonna do? Like, how are you gonna make money from that? And then fast forward to today, 2019, everybody and their mama wants to fucking make a YouTube. Or don't be afraid to put yourself out there. If you're pursuing a YouTube channel as well, keep at it, be consistent, be engaged, make content people wanna see. And I'm always thinking outside the box. I'm always thinking of content that I know y'all wanna see. So, cause I wanna be authentic. I wanna be, I don't wanna copy nobody else's content. Like, I wanna do my own shit. I wanna just set my own trends, you know what I'm saying? So, but yeah, and I really feel like I'm self-made, because when I first started this, like I was saying, nobody was really cheering for me. Nobody was really saying like, oh, go subscribe to Kirah's channel, I made a YouTube, blah blah blah. But a lot of people don't like me, so I know people were probably like, oh my god, this bitch made a YouTube, go look at her fucking video. So thank you to my haters that, you know, spread the word about me, because you want haters, because the haters are the ones that are gonna get the word around faster. So don't be mad if a bitch doesn't like you, because she's probably watching somewhere. Honestly, she probably got you up in her search bar. But yeah, like a lot of people really wasn't rooting for me, and I was my own cheerleader. So you gotta be your own cheerleader. You gotta be okay with people not supporting you, because when they see you doing it and doing it big, they're gonna want to do it too. They're gonna want to ask you, how did you do it? But they're not able to, because you know, you don't fuck with them. So we are gonna have whole new content up in 2020. Strong. I wanna just do a lot in 2020. I wanna come out with my own merch one day.
I want to come out with my own like line and shit. Like I just want to come out with my own shit. So yeah, this is something I always wanted to be, the face of my own brand. I always love clothes. I want something in my name, period. Like I cannot wait to meet y'all one day. Like I just can't wait to meet y'all. So let's take a toast, an ending out toast. So yeah y'all, that is it for this vlog. I hope you guys enjoyed. Don't forget to like, comment, subscribe, and don't forget to shop this hair. It's super bomb. I've been wearing it throughout the whole vlog. And yeah, so check the description box below. And yeah, I love y'all so much. I'm going to bed because I have to work in the morning. But I will see y'all in the next vlog. Bye.